everyone. Welcome to Berlin, Germany. My name is Rachel Fenlon. I'm a Canadian soprano and pianist, and I'm so grateful to get to have a recital with you today. I want to thank Pacific Opera Victoria for giving me a musical voice and this creative opportunity at this time, at a time where it's hard not to feel the weight of the imposed silence on the musical community. And I want to use this opportunity to explore a way of programming that I wouldn't necessarily explore otherwise. I thought about this opportunity, and I thought about over the last couple of months when all of the outside external expectations or pressures or what have you are removed, what is a recital and what could a recital really be when it's just you and the music? And so, for those of you who've seen me in performance, I've been lucky to be at Pacific Opera for the last couple of years doing recitals, and most recently in January of this year. And I like to frame recitals with two big song cycles. You know, I kind of call it the meat and potatoes, except I'm a vegetarian. And I wanted this time, instead of focusing on big works and interspersing things, I wanted to explore an idea that I have been thinking about and exploring on my own here in quarantine in Berlin. And it's more of a poetic idea. And it came from an image that I got. The image was simple. It was sunlight beaming through a window one day, and I was in a room in my house, and the sunlight makes a rainbow prism on the floor. And I looked at this, and I kept thinking about this image, and how beautiful it was, and how hopeful it felt. It's very simple. And from this feeling of the image, I wanted to create a program. So I'll start the first set. I'll talk to you in between sets of pieces. The first set, I will begin with Olivier Messiaen's Trois Melodies. These were written in 1930, and two of the texts are Messiaen himself. The middle text is Cécile Sauvage. And then we lean into Morton Feldman's unaccompanied voice piece called Only. Then we lead into a solo piano piece of Philip Glass called Etude No. 2, and Reynaldo Hahn's Leur Excuse. And what I hope to show with these pieces is a journey between connected harmonies and shared motives, and perhaps what I feel might be the beginning or the entry point to this image, this poetic image that I felt. So thank you, and enjoy.
Pourquoi est-ce que Thank you.